I need to speak to John Quinn.
One moment, please.
Thank you.
Hello?
This is John Quinn.
Yeah.
John, do you mow yards? You mow the yard over there at an empty house on Redwood Street?
Sure.
Well, listen, my name's Mr. Mercer. I live in the house next door.
Uh-huh.
You remember running into something when y'all was over there mowing?
No, sir, I sure don't.
Well, listen, I got a special bird feeder out in the front of my house.
Uh-huh.
And y'all knocked it over when you was over there mowing.
There's just one of us. That's all there is.
Yeah?
It's just myself.
That's what I'm talking about, when y'all was out there.
That empty lot?
Yes, sir, next to my house. I had a speckled titmouse bird feeder there. It was a special bird feeder.
I don't recall that at all.
Well, sir, what you done, you run over it, run into it with your riding mower, knocked her down and broke it.
I don't recall that at all. I sure would have known if I'd have knocked something down.
Yeah, by God, I knew I was going to get to run around. It's a special bird feeder. I bought it in the Virgin Islands, and I need to get y'all to take care of it and pay for it.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. I don't have any idea what you're talking about.
I'm talking about $150, or somebody's getting ready to get their ass whooped.
I'm sorry. I mean, you say y'all. I'm the only one that mows.
Well,
and I specifically remember I did not knock anything over.
Is that your red? You got a red Dodge truck?
Yes, sir. I surely
did. Well, by God, it was you then that knocked her down.
I tell you what, I sure don't remember that at all.
Well, you're getting ready to remember it because I'm coming over where you're at and getting about $150 out of you, or I'm whooping your ass. Maybe that'll jog your memory a little bit.
Well, maybe so.
Yeah.
Maybe so.
Because my wife's pretty tore up about it.
Well, like I said, sir, I don't recall anything knocking anything over.
It was a second anniversary present to what it was, I give her. We went down there on our honeymoon.
Well, like I say, I'm sorry, sir, but I don't recall.
Well, sorry, don't replace my speckled titmouse bird feeder.
You know.
Mr. Quinn.
So.
You know, I can appreciate you being tore up about it and sorry and all, but what I need is $150 because I need to order another titmouse bird
what
feeder.
What I'm telling you is how do I know that I broke it?
By God, I seen you do it.
You see, if you seen me do it, well, then how come didn't you come out there and say something to me?
I seen you hit it, but it didn't fall till about 3 days later.
Well, see, I did not knock anything over.
Well, what you done, you loosened it up,
okay,
and I'm getting ready to come over there and loosen
it.
I may come over there and loosen a couple of your teeth over.
Well, you know, hey, you know, sure.
How big a boy are you?
You know, I'm big enough to hold my own. I'm going to tell you that right now.
Well, I doubt that very seriously.
You know, all I have to say is, I did not knock any bird feeder over.
Because all you had to do
and
was fess up to
it. If I knocked it over, then you should have came out there right then.
Well,
and you should have come out there and told me, hey, you broke my bird feeder. This shit of it falling down 3 or 4 days later ain't going to work with me.
I guarantee you.
Okay?
What you done, you broke a pole or loosened it up in the ground and caused it to fall over.
Like I just said, if I broke that, you seen me break it, you should have came out there and you should have told me.
How long are you going to be there where you're at?
Okay?
How long are you going to be there?
That's all I got to say.
How long are you going to be there where you're at?
Dadgummit.
Dadgummit. I wonder if he edges as well as mows.
Hello?
John?
One moment, please.
Hello?
Listen, this is Mr. Mercer again. I found an old boy says he can repair that bird at Peter for about half a price that it cost to replace it. His name is Trey Brown.
Sure.
He said he also removes hooks from people's mouths, too.
Yeah. Yeah, I was waiting for the old boy to come over so I could bust a few of his teeth out.
Hey, Ryan.
Ryan. This is Phil and Brent and Roy Mercer from Tulsa, Oklahoma. How are you?
Well, how's it going?
We're pretty good.
Sorry, so bitches.